Hello children, welcome to I Love Science. Today we will talk about center of gravity. You know that center of gravity of any object is the point where it can be assumed that the complete mass of that object is centered at that place. In a long object, it is very easy to say where is the center of gravity. Now because this is uniformly weighted at the complete length, if we just go to the center of this place, we will say the center will be here. I will be able to balance this scale from the center, right? But if this scale heavy on one side and light on one side, then it is very difficult to say where is center of gravity. We will put some magnets on one side. Okay, now we don't know the weight of these magnets. Now we don't know where is the center of gravity. Now if we try to balance it somewhere, then it will either tilt on this side. If we balance here, it will tilt on this side. Okay, now if we have to find the center of gravity, then I will tell you very easy method. If you put your fingers like this, one on this side, one on this side, and then keep sliding them closer, you will see that automatically your fingers will move slowly and they will automatically meet at the new center of gravity of this scale, and I will be able to balance it here. So you see, now this is the new center of gravity of this scale. I am able to balance it from here now. So it has shifted because it is heavier on this side. Okay, now suppose we make it more complex and then add some weight on this side also. Now we don't know where is center of gravity. Again, we can do the same method, and then without holding to the scale, we can just move our fingers slowly. Left and right fingers will automatically move to the center without you having to do anything, and they will automatically meet at the new center of gravity. And you can see I have come to the new center of gravity. I am using this method on a scale. You can use it on any long object. For example, you can use a walking stick. So if there is somebody in your home who uses a walking stick, then you can take that walking stick. What I will do, I will take a plain wooden stick like this, make it unbalanced by hanging a weight on one side, and then see if I can reach at the center of gravity. So again, coming closer. See, right now this finger is moving, but this is not moving. Right side is not moving, only this is moving. Why? Because it is heavier on this side. And you cannot control this. It is automatically controlled by the friction between your fingers and the stick. And by moving them slowly, you will automatically reach the balancing point, which will be the center of gravity. Now, why does it happen? It happens because the friction between the stick and your finger is more on the side which side is heavy, right? So if you move from somewhere, so for example, if I move from this far, now you see it is heavier on this side, so friction here is more. When I move it, this finger will not move, only this finger will keep moving, unless it comes as close that friction on both of them is equal, and then both of them will slowly start moving and then come to the center of gravity. You can even do it on a scale. So for example, I have a scale here. Let me make it unbalanced. I am adding some magnets here, and now when I move my fingers, it will automatically come to the center of gravity of this scale, and I, without making it fall, I will be able to balance it on my fingers here, right? So it's a very interesting concept which explains us many physics concepts like center of gravity and friction, etc. So try to do this at your home and have fun. Thank you.